Here's a teardown for all you audiophiles out there. Bang & Olufsen's $500 Beoplay 11 wireless earbuds are on the iFixit teardown table. Looking exactly the same as the $400 Beoplay EXs, these new buds claim to improve on its predecessors and see functionality, but judging by the sticker, ours are apparently having an identity crisis. We actually had to double back and check our order, and we did indeed confirm that we received the Beoplay 11 with a Beoplay EX sticker on the bud. The big claim though that caught our attention is that these buds have a serviceable battery, and we're hopeful that this also means that they're user replaceable batteries. Engadget said B&O might be trying to meet the 2027 battery regulation in the European Union, but if the internals are anything like the EX, these buds wouldn't be in compliance anyway. There's really only one way of knowing how serviceable these buds are, and that's to try and open one up. There's no obvious entry point, so it's a safe bet that it's glued shut. Thanks to Lumafield's CT scanner, I can at least know where the battery is before going in. Now, I don't have a jig to fit this particular bud, so I'm using a jig made for AirPods, just to secure the device in place while I apply heat and a little bit of prying action. A couple of heating sessions later, and I can separate the outer half of the casing. Peeking through the gap, we can see the small PCB housing two MEMS microphones, an antenna, and once we fully lift one side of the case up, we can also free the circular capacitive touch layer. Let it be known, all of these components, including the battery, are still attached to the inner half of the case. No matter how much I pry, that fact won't change. In fact, the button cell battery is spot welded to a nickel strip that is soldered to the circuit board beneath it. Both the spot welds and the solder points will make the earbuds non-compliant with the upcoming EU battery law, which says that batteries must be removable without heat. We're going to have to disassemble the inner half of the buds too, which raises red flags for B&O's claims of a serviceable battery. This is already a very onerous and labor-intensive task at this point, even for a trained technician, who presumably will have access to specialized disassembly tools at one of B&O's service centers. Oh boy, this is something alright. Right off the bat, we can see a plastic weld mark barring access to the battery. That means that at a minimum, any battery replacement service would need to dispose of the plastic housing completely. After much prying, it becomes apparent that there are two solder points securing the nickel strip that's been micro-welded to the battery. Thankfully, my iFixit smart soldering iron is nearby and ready to go in 4 seconds flat. Removing one of those solder points allows me to remove the MEMS PCB before going back to tackle the second solder point. With the battery free, we can take a look at the internals. I would love to be proven wrong here, but that disassembly process has me questioning how replaceable these batteries really are. It has to be said though, unlike our AirPods teardowns, this device did come apart without any damage to the electronics. Speaking of the electronics, it's worth taking a moment to compare the engineering that went into the AirPods 4 when compared to the Beoplay 11. Now, reviewers will tell you that the performance of these buds are roughly similar, but Apple's prowess in the engineering department is never more evident than a side-by-side comparison under the CT scanner. The Beoplay 11 deploys two microphones in series on the stem, one to capture your voice for phone calls and another to hear sound from your surroundings for noise cancellation purposes. And it has a third microphone offset against the driver inside the ear, also for noise cancellation. The AirPods 4, on the other hand, take a no-compromise approach of placing one microphone at the bottommost tip of the stem, the exterior noise cancellation microphone at the outer curved edge, and the inner noise cancellation microphone directly in line with the eardrum. These placements are not easy to achieve, requiring a certain amount of obsessive over-engineering and deep pockets to execute, and should, in theory, give the AirPods an edge in ANC performance. Moving on to the case, we have the same style of clipped-in shell that we've seen in every major earbuds case design, with the notable exception of all AirPods products. This is great for repairability because, you guessed it, there's a disposable lithium polymer battery inside these cases. It feels like every component here was designed by competing ideologies towards repair though. Again, we see the repair-friendly ZIF connectors and the soldered wires side by side. With so much space to spare, there really is no reason not to use repair-friendly connectors throughout this case. At least the battery pouch itself is not soldered down, but the USB-C port is. This almost feels like a case of the old guard design of cheap and cheerful colliding head-on with new regulatory requirements for serviceable design. I feel the engineers met the regulatory requirements, but completely missed the point as to why they've been implemented. As a longtime fan of Bang & Olufsen, this is a very disappointing design that seems to be a good enough effort just to push a product out the door. With a lack of replaceable batteries, spare parts, and a complete absence of repair guides, the Bang & Olufsen Beoplay 11 achieves a repairability score of 1 out of 10, barely avoiding rock bottom.